हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू दिस सेशन ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग ग्राफिक्स एंड डिज़ाइन। माई सेल्फ विमल सलोद फ्रॉम एलजी इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी। इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सेक्शन ऑफ सॉलिड। सो फॉर दैट लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ द कटिंग प्लान फॉर द सेक्शन प्लान। फर्स्ट टाइप ऑफ कटिंग प्लान इज नोन एज हॉरिजॉन्टल कटिंग प्लान। In short form, it is written as HCP. So here it is HCP. What is the position of this cutting plane? It is parallel to HP and perpendicular to VP. When we cut any object by this type of cutting plane, the true shape of the section will appear in the top view. That is known as the sectional top view. Next type of cutting plane is vertical cutting plane. In short form, it is written as VCP. So it is the position of vertical cutting plane. It is parallel to VP and perpendicular to HP. When we cut any object with this type of cutting plane, true shape of the section will appear in front view. So front view itself is sectional front view, and it is true shape of the sectional view. Next type of cutting plane is profile cutting plane. Here the position of cutting plane is parallel to profile plane, and it is perpendicular to both HP and VP. When we cut any object by this type of cutting plane, as it is parallel to profile plane, the true shape of this section will appear in the side view. Next type of cutting plane is auxiliary inclined plane. In short form, it is written as AIP. It is the position of the cutting plane, and you can see here it is inclined at an angle of theta with HP, and it is perpendicular to VP. If any object is cut by this type of cutting plane, then true shape of the section and apparent shape both will be different. Next type of cutting plane is auxiliary vertical plane. The position of auxiliary vertical plane is, it is inclined at an angle phi with VP, and it is perpendicular to HP. If any object is cut by this type of cutting plane, then in this case also true shape of the section and apparent shape of the section both will be different. Now let's see one example. Here the given data is a square pyramid of base edge 40 mm and axis height 65 mm is resting on one of its corner on HP. It is cut by an AIP inclined at 45 degree to HP and passing through the midpoint of the axis. Draw its sectional top view and true shape of the section. So type of object is square pyramid, and first stage is same as we were drawing in case of projection of solid. So here it is resting on one of its corner on HP. So we have to start from the true shape of the base, that is the square, and as it is resting on corner, two corners should remain on extreme sides. That would be the square. So first draw reference line XY and draw the true shape of the square in such a way that two corners should remain on extreme sides. So here it is ABCD given square. Now locate the midpoint through which the axis of this pyramid passes. So for that, join the diagonally opposite corner and mark that point as O point. Draw the projector from all the points of the top view, and also draw the projector from the center point O. So through which, on this projector, on this line, it is the axis, and height of axis is given as 65 mm. So take this height as 65 mm. Now on axis, this OB edge and OD edge both are overlapping, and OB edge is visible, so there is no need to draw the axis over here. Height is taken as 65, and it is the front view of the given square pyramid. So it is the first stage where we are making the drawing same as we were doing in case of projection of solid. Now for second stage, we have to consider the section plan, and for that we have to first locate the position of the cutting plane according to given condition. Here EIP is given and it is inclined at 45 degree to HP and passing through the midpoint of the axis. So midpoint is at a distance of 32.5 mm either from the base or from the apex side. So here it is the position of the cutting plane. It is at a distance of 32.5 mm and it is inclined at 45 degree. CP is the given cutting plane. Now we have to locate the cutting points. You can see here the object is cut by this cutting point. You can see here the object is cut by this cutting plane at different positions. So which are the edges being cut by this cutting plane? Here this O plus A dash slant edge is cut by this cutting plane. So let's mark that point as 1 dash. Then OB, OC and OD, all the four edges are cut by the cutting plane. So we have to mark that cutting point. So in sequence, first we have started from the OA edge. So OA edge is cut at point number 1. Then OB edge is cut at point number 2. Then OC edge is cut at point number 3. And OD edge is cut at point number 4. Now all these cutting points are located, and from all these points we have to draw the projection in top view so that we can draw sectional top view. So draw the projector from 1 dash, and 1 dash is the cutting point for OA edge. So on OA this point 1 is marked. Then OC edge is cut at point number 3, so projector is drawn from this 3 dash point, and on OC mark the top view of 3 dash, that is point number 3. Now what about point number 2 and 4? These are the cutting points which lies on the same line as here it is shown. So for that we have to make some additional step, draw horizontal line as shown here up to this slant edge, 4 dash, 8 dash, and from this point draw the vertical projector in downward direction. So it is the point which we got as the radius. So now take compass size equal to from O point up to this point, it is the radius, and draw a semicircle as shown here. So here we have two points, 2 number and 4 number on OB and OD edge. Now join all these points in sequence. So it is the area which is bounded by 1, 2, 3, 4, and it is being cut by the cutting plane. Draw the etchings or section line on this area as it is the material which is being cut by the cutting plane. So it shows the apparent shape and it is the sectional top view. Now we have to draw true shape of the section. When we see this object from this direction, that is direction perpendicular to the cutting plane, we can see the true shape of the section. So for that we have to make some additional procedure. Draw another reference line, x1 y1 line, parallel to the cutting plane line as shown here. Now from all these cutting points, 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash, draw the projectors. So here the all projectors are drawn. All these projectors are perpendicular to the CP line at the particular points 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash. Now we have to locate these points 1, 2, 3 and 4, all these projectors. So for that, first consider point number 1. So distance of point number 1 from this reference line XY, let's take that distance as H1. As you can see here, this distance is considered as H1 distance. So with that similar distance, we have to mark the point on this projector drawn from the point number 1 dash. So here it is the point number 1 at a distance of H1. Point number 3 is at the same distance from XY line. So mark this point number 3 at the same distance from X1 by 1 line. That is point number 3. And now for point number 2 and 4, measure the distance of these points from XY line, and on that particular projector, mark these points as point number 2 and 4, and join these points in sequence. So that is the true shape. Also draw the hatchings on the true shape. So it shows the true shape. So whenever any object is cut by AIP or by AVP, apparent shape and true shape both are different. So here in this diagram, it is front view, it is sectional top view, and it is the true shape of the section. Thanks for watching.